Okay, folks, listen, in this video, I'm going to show you a few scenes from a movie called Daybreakers, starring William Dafoe. And you will see why I'm bringing it up soon. But before I start, I just want you to understand that there is many, many movies that have Elvis connections that I have shown in the past. But because my videos and channels were taken down recently by YouTube, I am not going to rehash all those videos. But this particular one that I've shown before, I am, because it is important for you to see this one. So it's a Lionsgate movie. They're the ones who financed it, I guess. So I guess this is just like a preview. It says, imagine a world where almost everyone is a vampire, and the very few humans that are remaining are hunted and farmed for blood.
What happens when there isn't a single drop left?
We only have enough blood to sustain our population till the end of the month.
We need your help.
We want to rebuild the human race.
A blood substitute is not a cure.
I was like you once,
and not no more.
Who are you?
So the key figure here is William Dafoe, because he has the cure to make the vampires human. So here they explain how William Dafoe figured out what the cure for to no longer be a vampire. So he was driving along in the daytime, and all his, because he's a vampire, so he can't have light, but it was daytime. He was driving around, and all his windows are tinted dark. So, he has only like a little hole where he could see through the front of the windshield. But this is how he figured out, watch.
Trouble is, if you ain't careful, you can get yourself one hell of a sunburn. You can only go on so long without blood before it messes with your head. Amazing how quickly your whole world can change. Ain't it, Doc?
We need to recreate this safely. That's why we need you.
So what happened is, after his body was thrown from the car, he was, the daylight set him on fire, and he died basically in the water. But see, what happened was, because he was in the water, and then he came out, like being born again. Do you understand? And then they said the sun saved him. Okay, because I told you, they're going to birth ELVIS out of the sea in Seattle, okay? And this is what they're representing here, and you'll see why I'm saying that. So in the movie, the first time we see this Willem Dafoe character, and I'm going to show you why I'm showing you this video, okay? Why I'm doing this video. The first time we see the William Dafoe character is under this tree. And, you know, this kind of represents, like, you know, the tree of good and evil, okay? You'll see why I'm saying that.
Lionel Cormack. My friends call me Elvis.
So, like I said, this is the first time we see who this character is. And look at his name. It says Lion L. It's got the lion and the E-L, and E-L means God. And, you know, that's made by Lionsgate, this movie. And then they wrote, and then he says, my friends call me Elvis. You see that? And this guy is the you know, vampire who figured out the cure. Okay, you understand? The cure. Because I told you, Elvis is going to be seen as the savior of the world. Everyone's going to take his mark. And they're going to worship him.
Lionel Cormack. My friends call me Elvis. I ain't gonna bite.
Look at that, shaking hands with the devil, Elvis.
Elvis.
Yeah.
You know, like, Lord Almighty, feel my temperature rising. Higher, higher, it's burning through.
And remember, like I said, I have two predictions, and Elvis is going to somehow manifest on 6/11, his name, his image, or the number of his name on June 11th, 6/11 in Seattle. And interestingly enough, Willem Dafoe, you know, his name sounds like friend or foe, right? The foe. And he was born on July 22nd, and I told you guys, if you know my video, July 22nd is the backwards date of June 11th, the day I'm telling you Elvis appears. July 22nd is June 11th, backwards, all right? If you don't know what I'm talking about, just ask in the comments section, and I'll explain it. Anyway, and also he's 66 years old, and 66 is the twin number. I told you Elvis was a twin. Oh, and he's also born in 55, the same year Bill Gates was born. And Bill Gates was born in Seattle. And this Willem Dafoe, he was in a movie called The Last Temptation of Christ, which is the most blasphemous thing you can imagine, this movie. Willem Dafoe is going to go to the deepest, darkest depths of hell, this dude. And remember, I showed you that how he was saved. He crashes, goes through the windshield, burns, dies, you know, goes into the water. He's dead. And then he's born again. Do you understand? He comes out of the water and he's born again. And remember, his name is Elvis in the movie. And I told you, Elvis, they're going to birth L, okay? Elvis has the E-L. They're going to birth L out of Seattle, the waters in Seattle, the sea in Seattle. And remember, I told you, E-L means God, and Elvis's first two letters is E-L, all right? Elvis. So let's see what birth L equals, because I told you Seattle's going to birth the L. Birth L equals 7438-115-43. So remember that. For birth L, 7438-115-43. It equals the exact same as Lucifer. Lucifer equals 7438-115-43. I told you Elvis is playing the part of Lucifer. Okay? That's why he was adorned in jewels. And he's wearing a cape of the Phoenix Bird in concert. See, this is his outfits in concert. You know, look, it's got the Phoenix Bird. Also can be an eagle or a thunderbird. And he's wearing a cape. Like I said, he's adorned in jewels. Just like Lucifer was when he was in heaven. And just like I showed you, Lucifer equaled birth L, same exact numbers. You know, Elvis was known as the king. The king almost equals the exact same. Every number is the same except this one. 74, 38, 115. Lucifer was 43. This is 34. Same numbers, but just turned around for the king. That's why they called Elvis the king, because it's got to do with Lucifer.
Lionel Cormack. My friends call me Elvis. My friends call me Elvis. I ain't gonna bite.
Shaking hands with the devil.
Elvis.
Yeah.
You know, like, Lord Almighty, feel my temperature rising. Higher, higher, it's burning through to my soul.
You know, if Willem Dafoe had steroids, he'd kind of look like Arnold Schwarzenegger. Anyway, let me tell you something. If you still think that it's not enough connection to Elvis, this movie, you know, besides his name being Elvis and everything else I showed, let's see when this movie Daybreakers came out. So Daybreakers was released on January 8th. And why is that important? That's the same day Elvis was born, January 8th. Okay? It's not a coincidence. Out of 365 days, that's the one day that they chose to release that movie, Daybreakers, which had an Elvis connection. Elvis is going to save the world, birthing L. And remember, I told you that Elvis is known as the king, and Seattle's in King County, and Seattle's in Washington State. Washington State is the 42nd state, and Elvis died at the age of 42. So remember, Elvis died at the age of 42, right, in 1977. But if Elvis was alive right now, okay, because, you know, Elvis, the word Elvis equals lives, right? It's an anagram for the word lives. Elvis. And if he was still alive on his birthday, which is coming up in a few days, January 8th, look at this. First of all, it's got the 777 in the days, 31,777 days. That's how old he would have been. But this is what's important, okay? 87 years old. And watch this crazy coincidence, what I'm about to show you, which I left out of my other video that had to do with the 87 age. So remember, Elvis died at 42 and he's 87 years old coming up this year in a few days. Watch this. So remember, I told you that going to birth Elvis out of the sea in Seattle, right? And Elvis is going to be born again. So it's going to be his birthday again. But this time he's not going to be born on January 8th. He's going to be born on June 11th out of the sea in Seattle. Let's look at what birthday equals. Look at this, will you? Look at this. I mean, can you believe this? Watch. So birthday equals 87. At 42. Elvis died at 42 and he's turning 87 this year on January 8th. And I told you 2022 is the year, folks. Look at this. And yes, there's a 216 in here too, because the 216th day of the year is August 4th, which Obama's birthday, where Trump gets his head wound and he survives. But Elvis returns on June 11th. Look at that. 87, he turns January 8th, and he died at 42. You can't make this stuff up, folks. This is unbelievable, what you're seeing. Okay, folks, I got to end the video. So remember, these are my two predictions, and don't forget it. End of video.